Hello students, so we are going to start the process of fitting. So in the pharmaceutical engineering, as we have completed the unit of size reduction, the next process in the pharmaceutical operation, it is none other than your size separation. So as we have already discussed, I have given in my previous video regarding the sieves. So how this sieve, they work? What are the different methods we use in the process of sieving? So we are going to discuss. So basically, if we see the process of sieving, first of all we have to see the process of mechanical sieving. So mechanical, the word itself, it reminds us mechanical means use of energy, that is a physical process. So in the mechanical process, there are basically agitation method, sieve brushing method, and centrifugal force, right? So what is a agitation method? Now the agitation method is a very simple method that has been used, or that can be used in our household activity. Even we have sometimes performing in our day-to-day life activity. Suppose here I have considered, this is my hand, suppose here I have considered a simple household strainer that we used to strain the tea leaves, right? So this is a simple strainer. I have put some powder here, right? Now in this strainer, if I hold the strainer with my hand, this strainer, I can perform the method, that is the agitation method. How we are going to perform? Simply, you can move this strainer. I have shown you the direction. Simply forward direction, backward direction, just like this, right? Or sometimes we can even give a direction of upward and downward in this way. But upward and downward movement we generally don't prefer, as because the grains or the powder that can come out from the strainer, right? Moreover, the next method, it is your sieve brushing. So in sieve brushing, what we used to do? It's a very simple method. So in sieve brushing, generally suppose this is a sieve. Suppose this is a sieve, here we have placed the grains. We can use a simple paint brush. The sieve will remain as it is. It is in a stationary position. It will remain as it is, right? Here, the grains are there. We are going to apply the brush here. These are the, suppose, the bristles of the brush. We are going to apply it like this, in this way. So while applying the brush over the grain, the grains or the powdered drug, they will get some sort of mechanical force, by virtue of which it will come down, the smaller particle will come down like that. Here, then this is the sieve brushing. Then we have the process of vibration. So what is the vibration? Vibration, it's a energy which is given to jerk or to move a stationary substance, right? So if suppose in a sieve, suppose this is a sieve, right? With any number, this is a sieve. Here we have kept the powdered drug. Now if we provide the vibration energy here, the grains, they will start vibrating, right? Due to this vibration, what may happen? Suppose we have a mixture of small grains, we have a mixture of bigger grains, right? They will go in continuous movement, right? The smaller grains will come down, they can easily pass through this, right? They can easily pass through this, whereas the bigger grain, they will remain over the sieve, right? In this way, you can do the vibration. So there is an arrangement. I will show you how to perform this experiment. So there is an arrangement where we are going to arrange a set of sieve, right? Now, in the process of the vibration, what we are going to do? We are going to arrange the sieve. Generally, we used to arrange around approximately 12 number of sieves in this pattern. So this is a sieve shaker. It's a very basic instrument which is used in the pharmaceutical engineering unit operations. So this is a sieve shaker. Here, we have 12 number of C. Right, I have shown it like A, B, C, D and E like that. Now, what will be the or what is the arrangement of sieve here? So, how the sieves are arranged? We all know that if we see here, the sieve number suppose 6, it will have an aperture size of suppose we take it as 1000. Then sieve number 7, it will have an aperture size of suppose 800. Right, this may be square meter, right. So sieve number 10 will have suppose 500. In this way, if we increase, keep on increasing the number of the sieve, we know that if we keep on increasing the number of the sieve, the size of the aperture, or you can say the size of the mesh size in the sieve, it keeps on decreasing. So how these are arranged? Here, we are going to start with the sieve number 6 at the A. Here, we are going to use sieve number 6. Here, suppose sieve number 10. Here, in the C, suppose sieve number 50. Here, sieve number 80. You will keep on increasing the number so that the size of the mesh or the size of the aperture, it is going to get decreased gradually. Right? What we are going to do? Here, we are going to give the powder drug. Now this powder drug, it will flow, or first it will settle here. Once we are going to switch on the machine, it will start generation of vibration energy, right? So once the vibration energy it has started, the powder drug, it will come down based on the size. The fine particle, they will be collected here, moderately fine. So now percentage, or you can say sieving percentage. What is the sieving percentage? So basically, you see, here we have arranged, I have shown you the arrangement. So, residue which is present in each sieve. Suppose sieve A, it have a residue, the topmost sieve, it have a residue, suppose 50 gram. Divided by total weight of the powder, suppose we have taken 500 gram of the powder for sieving. Right? Into 100. So sieve percentage is nothing but simply 50 divided by 5 is equal to 10%. Now the thing is that we have to keep few points in our mind while using the sieve shaker. This thing has to be kept generously while performing this step. These are number one, suppose nature of the drug. Nature of the drug. Suppose our drug is hygroscopic in nature. Hygroscopic means the drug has the tendency to entrap the moisture from the atmosphere, right? So if the drug it is hygroscopic in nature, what it is going to do? It is going to entrap the moisture and finally they are going to aggregate together and they are going to form the lump. If they form a lump, if the drug they form a lump, this will decrease the efficiency of the process. Clear? This will decrease the efficiency of the process. Sometimes what may happen, suppose this is a sieve. Suppose generally we have considered this is a sieve. Here, there drug particles are there, right? Now vibration it is taking by virtue of the vibration machine that is, or the setup, right? Now what can happen, sometimes suppose these drugs, particles, they may collide with one another, even they can collide with the wall of the sieve. Suppose this is, it is made up of steel. There are some drugs which have a tendency to induce charge. Suppose few particles will attain positive charge, like this, few will attain negative charge. Now what will happen? The positive particles, they are going to get attracted with the negative particles, again they are going to form lump. In such cases, we have to be cautious because lump formation, it is not desirable in this process. Clear? So basically, to perform it in a generous way, what we prefer generally, drug should be dry, or sometimes we used to prefer the drug to, means to get dry before the starting the process. So next process, we are going to start now. The next process of unit operation of the size separation here it is. Okay, now the next method, it is your centrifugal method. So centrifugal method, so what we are going to perform here, suppose the centrifugal method, it is although a very contemporary method, but it is still used, centrifugal method. So let's understand the concept first. So what actually is performed here, we generally used to have a cylinder like this. Suppose a bigger cylinder will be there like this. At the bottom of the cylinder, we are going to have one fan-like structure. Suppose a fan-like structure, suppose blades. These are the blades, they can rotate. Suppose these are the blades, this is a fan-like structure. Although my drawing is not good, but you can just assume this is a fan-like structure. It is having, these are the blades of the fan, right? These are the blades of the fan. Now, it is associated with a motor. What we are going to do, we are going to put the drag here, right? We are going to switch on the motor. As soon as the motor, it will start moving the fan here, what will happen? Turbulence, flow of air will take place. Turbulence, flow of air will take place in such direction, in the direction of the fan, moving fan, right? What will happen? This is actually fit for fine particles separation or fine particle sieving. In some cases, what actually happens? Here we can sometimes keep sieve also. So the basic function is here that if we zoom this part, if we see here, suppose this is the wall of the cylinder, right? Now, as the air is moving fastly, this air will make the particle to hit the surface of the cylinder. Once it will hit the surface, immediately it will fall down, and in such way the fine particles will be collected first, then the coarser particles. This is a contemporary method, but nowadays many modification has been done in the centrifugal method. Now we are going to start the next part, that is the wet granulation process. So what we actually perform or what we actually do in the wet granulation process, we are going to discuss now. Okay, now the next method of size separation, it is known as, or sieving, it is known as the wet sieving method. Now in the pharmaceutical operation, generally we used to consider the wet sieving method to be more preferential as compared to that of the dry sieving method, because the wet sieving method is generally, they don't produce dust, and production of dust is not preferable for potent drug in pharmaceutical operation. If the drug is potent in nature, then production of dust, if that somehow goes to the worker, it may cause havoc. So this is the process. Next process is known as wet sieving method. So wet sieving method basically have the sedimentation method. So in the sedimentation method, sedimentation method can be divided into two types. Number one, it is the sedimentation tank method. Number two, it is the continuous sedimentation tank. So what is the sedimentation tank, or how the function is done? So sedimentation tank, it is a very simple method. Suppose we will have a tank. Here we are going to have one tank. In this way, suppose we are having one tank. The tank will be filled up with fluid, preferentially water, right? Now we are going to give the drug here in the powdered form. But the thing is that it should be keep in the mind that the drug should not be water soluble. If the drug is water soluble, then this process is useful. If the drug is not water soluble, then it will be helpful. So what we are going to do, if we give the mixture of the drug after the size reduction, if we allow it in this tank, what will happen? After some time, the drug here, they are going to settle, they are going to form different layer. Suppose here, you will get a layer. After this part you are going to get another layer here, right, in this way. So the basic thing is that first of all here we are going to scrap it. Suppose we will have one scraper, we are going to scrap the layer from this. We are going to take it out. This first layer, it consists of generally fine particles. As the fine particles, they have low weight, they will be at the top level. The next particle, or the next layer, they are the coarser particle, which will have more weight. And the last one, it will be the bigger particle, it will be made up of the bigger particle. Here the particle size will be more. But this process is not efficient, because sometimes what may happen, the fine particles from this layer, from the top layer, sometimes they may come and mix with the coarser particle or bigger particle at the bottom layer. This is due to their fine arrangement, right? So this is the simple sedimentation tank. Now if we see the other part, this is the continuous sedimentation tank. Now how the continuous sedimentation tank it works. See, here we are going to have one tank like this, right? We are going to have one tank like this. So these are the two arrangements. So one, it is the inlet, the other one, it is the outlet. Right, the water or the solvent here present, it will be forced through this. After filling up, it will leave the vessel. Now here two parameters or two forces, they act simultaneously. I am showing you here the two forces. Number one force, it is the horizontal force. This horizontal force is due to the pump. It is giving the force in this way so that the water can move out. The water, it will have the drug particle. The horizontal force, it will try to take out the drug. Right. The next one, it will be the vertical force. Now what is vertical force? The vertical force, the horizontal force will act in this direction. The vertical force will act in this direction. The vertical force will act downward in this direction by virtue of the gravity. Right? Now you see what actually happens here. The horizontal force, it is going in this direction. Right? The water, it is trying to move in this direction. Now if now we give a mixture here which has both the bigger size particle as well as the smaller size particle. The bigger size particle, what they will do after attaining this particular position, the bigger size particle will come down because they have high weight, they cannot move to a long distance. They will immediately settle here. The bigger size particle will immediately settle here at this region, right? Whereas the fine particle or ultra fine particle, they will move in this way. The ultrafine particle will get settled here. The ultrafine particle will get settled here. Although this is not as per the sieve, but sometimes sieve can be also arranged here in this area. Means aperture. So the bigger particle, they are going to settle here by virtue of the gravitational force, right? They are going to settle here. Whereas the smaller particle, by virtue of the horizontal force, due to the force of the water, they are going to settle here. After some time, you can separate the bigger size particle and the smaller size particle. So this is the arrangement of the continuous sedimentation